Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome back to my Watch Dogs Let's Play on the PlayStation 3. Let's pick up where we left off, controlling Aiden Pearce, an elite hacker in the city of Chicago. Check into the hotspot. It's the Face Fountain! No, Chicago is not being invaded by monsters with giant heads. Situated in Millennium Park, this unique fountain is a cross-section of city life and digital art. Oh, those fancy artists and their wacky inspirations. I'm guessing the inspiration for this fountain involved cubes. Lots of cubes. Just guessing.
Tell me how to get close to Iraq.
You ain't getting close to Iraq, man. Forget it. He never comes out.
You want to rethink your answer?
Wait. The auction. He'll be at Quinn's auction.
What kind of auction?
Private. Not your normal kind of auction. Invite only.
So get me an invite.
Who do you think I am?
All right. I'll be in touch. Be ready.
Oh, he'll be ready, all right. He'll be ready for action at the auction. If the next mission isn't called Action Auction, I'll be disappointed.
How did it go? Did you find a way into IREC's building?
Yeah, bedbug's on board and waiting for my call. Let's talk about the access card Iraq was wearing. That's our only way into his room.
It's an RFID tag. We can clone it, but you need to get very close.
Bedbug says Iraq's attending an auction. That's my chance.
The auction, yes. Remember that briefcase Iraq had?
Hard to forget. Crushed the guy's skull with it.
Right. He said it had the guest list inside. You can thank me now, because I've been checking that case. Now let me check.
That was quick thinking. If we get that briefcase, can you find me a name on the guest list? A name I can borrow.
Exactly my thoughts. I'm sending the briefcase location now.
All to save my kidnapped sister. This is a more convoluted plot than the fourth season of 24. And did I just say plot? Because that's funny. That's humor you can't write, folks. I said plot instead of plot. Oh, I don't want to do an online race right now. I'll hack you instead.
You left the car lights on! No. You did! Battery is dead! Gotta jump! Sick of this shit! Sick of your shit!
Wow, I'm glad we had that conversation.
I feel like a failure.
You must have accomplished something.
No, nothing. I'm gonna end my life at the cube thing over here. Well, I hate to break it to you.
When your friend's contemplating suicide, just give him a gentle push. $6,000! Whoa, this guy must be doing pretty good for himself. Let's check out Cloudgate. Ugly looking thing. It's like a giant pretzel.
You think you can talk to me like that?
Hey! Fuck you!
I'm Batman, motherfucker!
A massive illegal shipment of weapons has been uncovered. Police
really?
Were led to the shipment thanks to information leaked to them. Police say they won't investigate the source of the information, treating it as an anonymous tip.
Cool. Well, have that going for us. I think I have one more skill thing now, don't I? Ooh, I have two more skill things. We have anything and everything is at my fingertips to buy. Precision driver, tire low transit blowout, off-road driver, da-ba-da-ba-da, offensive driver, escape artist, effective when evading choppers, ATM hack boost, extra battery, disable reinforcement calls. I said that was one I wanted to get. What do we have in crafted? Focus boost and proxy IED. Combat, what do we have for combat? Critical focus, that's not bad. Shotgun damage against vehicles, don't really use that. And then demolitionist, I don't use explosives that often. Increase the amount of carried explosives, increasing the amount even more. I'm gonna get the one I said I was gonna get, which is in a hacking tree. Disable reinforcement calls. Yes! And then there's literally nothing else I can afford with only the 1 point. Let's take a look at our stats. Total money, 151,000, 22,000 of that unclaimed. I have hacked 10 of 13 CTOS towers. I am a protector level unit, and I am one third of the way through the Watch Dogs title, and we've been playing, this is a long game. A very fun and involved and deep game, and we still have a number of missions to go in Act 2. So, all right, so after a break in recording, Aiden Pearce and I are back to terrorize the city of Chicago and download some QR codes and stuff. So since we last spoke, which for you, I realize, was seconds ago in this very video, but for me, it was about a week ago, I have gone ahead and, well, there's a QR code, so we have to find a camera that's opposite. It's somewhere over on this big-ass building, right? Right like that. Right. I'm going to climb up on the railroad and see if I do it. So I was saying, since I last recorded, I decided to just do some off-recording playtime, and I probably played for like 5 or 6 hours. Didn't record anything, but I didn't play any story missions either, so you haven't missed anything. But what I did do, and I'll show you on the map here, besides changing Aiden's outfit to a blue trench coat, is I went in, and you can see now, well, maybe you can't, because the map's confusing. I've gone in and checked in at all the city hotspots on the south half of the map, this big area, these like three islands here. Checked into all the hotspots, did all the fix your contracts, QR codes, investigations, CTOS breaches, towers, all that shit, right? So, basically, I spent a couple afternoons outside of the recording to do all this extra shit. And now the game is 51% complete. And I also, thanks to my efforts, managed to, got 10 of these, 12 out of 16, 13 of those, 17 out of 30, 20 out of 23. So I've been making a lot of progress on the side missions because I wanted to beef up my skills tree. And I have 4 points. I'm waiting for a fifth. So I can buy either the auto weapons expert or the, I already grabbed defensive driver. Then yeah, I'll probably get the auto weapons expert. That was probably the next one on my list. And I unlocked a couple of trophies during my travels, and I am making my way to the platinum trophy, slowly but surely. So there's the QR code again, you can see it right there. I just need to find a camera that's it needs to be way, way up high, it seems like. So I'm going to grab this QR code because I'm in the area. And then we'll go back and we'll do some more story missions. We're already like 34 videos into this Let's Play at this point. I was originally only planning to do like 20 of them. But I feel like we should wrap up the second act before I call this quits. So that's what I'll head to.
Everything that makes your life easier consists of the same basic materials. The planet will soon run out of these materials. We've already exhausted over half our supply in the last 100 years at production.
All right, thanks, pal. I get it. Why did he keep saying materials, right? It sounded like with a D. D as in Delta, like, you freak. So I still haven't got a lot of the side missions inside downtown, inside the loop. But on like the, on the islands to the south and to the west, I've basically done everything that you can do there. I got a gold medal on one of the cash runs. I played the drinking game. I played the stupid guess what cup the balls under shit. Did all those stupid little city games that are all over the place. That unlocked the trophy. Another one I got earlier this morning was kill 4 guys inside a single instance of focus, which I've since upgraded all the way to maximum after playing 10 games of chess, which it turns out chess is actually not a full game of chess, but chess-related challenges. And that was originally why I decided not to play it on the actual, on the Let's Play, the recording here, because I worried that it would be, and it probably, honestly, it would have been kind of boring if I had recorded it, but I had a lot of fun playing it, by myself. But they were challenges. You'd have a queen, there would be 12 pawns on the board, and it was like, take all 12 pawns in exactly 12 moves or less. Or obviously not less, but 12 moves. So you had to kind of plan your moves and take out the pieces without wasting any spots. And It was a nice little thought exercise. I also did a couple digital trips.
Crazy, man.
Which I am anxious to do another one for you and to record. But for now, we continue the story, which will be, like I said, the focus of the actual recordings. And I haven't done this yet, so. The blind run continues.
Carefully. If I can count on anything, Damien will be working in an angle. He's got another agenda. Okay, right now I need that briefcase.
The briefcase with the guy's blood all over it? In Irak's room? Oh.
The boss wanted me to explain just how important this is. You're not just carrying a case of names and invites. You're carrying the future of power.
Tail. Follow the briefcase unseen. Good old Joey Michaels. Joey Jojo, acquitted of threats to Alderman.
The environment wants you to read this.
You can't destroy Alderman. It's a peaceful planet. They never did anything to the Empire. Shut up, Leia. Are they just passing it off from one schmuck to the next?
Do you see the case?
I do. It's moving. Wait. I can't believe it.
What?
Quinn's guys are pulling some old school gangster shit. Briefcase swap. Really?
Do those actually work?
Never seen one of these. Why are they doing this? Did they fool CTOS?
Anybody watching through a monitor would see every swap.
They're trying to confuse the detection software. Interesting.
Well, the detection software swaparoo ain't gonna work, okay? Now, do I have to actually tail him, or can I just, like, hack into a camera nearby and watch him peacefully from wherever I can be safe, you know? Don't mind me. I'm not, like, following gang. Like, stop putting down your, like, he walked 6 fucking feet and put his briefcase down and someone else picks it up. And they all look like gangsters. They're all wearing tracksuits in their mid-40s in white, like, all right, well, to be fair, it's Chicago, but Mel, they should still maybe stick out. I'm not losing the target. Don't tell me what to do. Is he getting on a boat? All right, you're not fooling anybody, dude. Hey, don't talk to me. What's your name, little girl? Chun Chang. Don't talk to me.
You're kind of creepy.
I'm on a very important mission.
They got the case on a boat heading upriver. They got a bike here. I'm gonna follow.
Maybe I can see where they're going. Give me a sec.
What do you have nearby? My guess, this will be a short trip. There's another drop for another pickup.
Okay. Nope. Nope. Wait. There's an old marina bought by Lucky Quinn in 1967.
That's gotta be it.
Says it's been closed to the public since the 80s.
I don't care. I've been closed since the 80s. That hasn't stopped me from getting some. I don't even know what that means, to be honest. He mentioned something about a bike. I think I was supposed to follow him on a bike, but I didn't see a bike, so I grabbed the boat, which it turns out you can drive in this game. Yeah, this reminds me of that time I went on a Chicago River tour in that episode of John's Adventure Vlog, which hopefully you got a chance to check out, because it was like this exact route. I've been here in real life. Except in real life, you have to go through the locks over there. It's not just straight shot right to the lake. It doesn't work like that. The lake is like 3 feet lower than the river. What's going on here? What are you doing? Where are you headed in your little boat? Your little fancy boat here. Look at me, I have a boat. Yeah. I'm not losing the target, he's right there. Is he docking at this marina? It looks like he's docking here. It looks like this is the place where he's going. Thank you. Ah, damn it. I think I fucked this up. Oh, I definitely fucked this up. Get it. Get in the boat. Get back in the boat. All right, so is this like the final stop? Do I have to worry about being seen here? What did I just crash into? More rocks? This thing's fiberglass. It'll be fine. Shut the fuck up. All right. What is this platform thing? It's no biggie. Get out. Get out of the fucking... Get out of the boat, Aiden. What are you doing? Stuck playing with himself all the time. He's a loser. Don't mind the guy that just crawled out of the water in a trench coat who hid behind a box 4 feet in front of you. Don't mind me. If I go to that next spot, I think I will be in his range. I think I can take him out undetected, though. But I am going to try for that. I am going to try for this next location here, which I think is... Infiltrate the marina. Okay, yeah, no problem, man. No problem. Huh? Like, how does he... What? How dumb is your patrol guard? How dumb are they? The answer will surprise you. It's very... No, that wasn't surprising? You're right. What? Dun 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 dun. I can't get around. Oh, can I? Okay, there's a little dock down here. Let's pop a scanner. Alright, so this place is crawling with goads. Can I see in here? I want to kind of see in here without getting in here. It looks like the inside area is empty. Huh. That's okay. That's cool. I'll pick up this stuff. I'll keep going. Nice try, Quasimodo. I can't get to that camera yet. You didn't hear anything. Shut up. Disrupt comms. Who's this guy? Harvest black market organs. This guy. I already saw him. This guy. Avid video game player. Oh, so am I! We have something in common. I'm still gonna shoot you in the head, though, sorry. 2 weeks sober. Okay, I was worried that maybe one of these guys had a reinforcements job and I was gonna disable it. So that's where I need to get? Is that right? It looks like I'm going the wrong way. It looks like I could have went around the building the other way and got right to the briefcase without anybody spotting me. But, there's not too many people over here, so I might as well just take them out, right? Shit. He might have heard something. He might have heard his friend die. Oh, no! It's okay, don't mind me. I'm not infiltrating your pathetically disorganized series of guards and infrastructure. Pay no attention to the man with the gun behind the crate. Everybody's dead. Thank you. Boom, ba-dum, boom. I have to use it? I can't take it? Escape the marina. Do I need to escape? I've killed everybody. Like, I already pretty much... or are they going to send reinforcements? Like, this is a story mission, not a fixer contract, so I feel
sending
like
the guest list
when it
the
feels
face.
Over, they
Whatever
double
this
down.
Action is, club's not taking chances. Security will be tight.
Okay, so we'll find you a suitable identity. Not a regular.
Someone from out of the country. A guy they won't recognize.
Okay. Okay. This one. Can you pull off a Mr. Pang?
I don't think so. Any Europeans?
Nicholas Crispin. 32 years old. Expat American. Haven't been back in 12 years.
That's the one.
Oh my god. They list his preferences. This man is sick. And filthy rich, too.
Will anyone miss him?
What do you mean, miss him?
Clara, if I'm stealing his identity, I can't have him around blowing my cover. I can't keep him alive.
Oh. No, I guess not.
My sister's missing, Clara. I'm gonna do whatever it takes to get her.
Including killing, like, eight
Listen,
other people.
If this is too much for you, you can walk away. I'll understand.
No.
Did I hit an invisible wall?
Nobody's going to miss this dog. This is a good match. He's supposed to pick up his car at the dealership.
Give me the directions.
All right. I'll meet him there.
Breadcrumbs. Mission complete. And honestly, that one wasn't that tricky at all. I thought we were going to have like a big escape. Reinforcements were going to get called in. I leveled up, I think. I don't know what the fuck leveling up in this game even means. What does it do? What does it do? I still don't know.
Hi, this is Aiden, Jack's uncle. I want to make sure things are going okay there.
First, I want to know if things are okay with Nikki. We haven't heard from her.
Oh yeah,
she's
been
still
kidnapped.
Working things out. She just needs a little more time.
Well, Jackson misses her terribly. She should at least give him a call. I can tell he's restless. He's not happy here.
I understand. And I'll let her know. If you have any problems with Jackson, anything at all, if he wanders off or anything, you call me right away.
I will. You take care of that sister of yours.
Yeah. I am.
Yeah. Yeah, all right. No problem, Jack. Yeah, I got it. Yeah. Yeah. Can I jump off of this bridge and not die? I think yes. Oh! I thought wrong. I'm sorry. I was wrong. Okay, it happens. Sorry. I mean, I miscalculated. And you know what happens when you miscalculate? You make a miss out of you and calc. That was a bad joke. Apologize. I was heading over to this hat spot. I wanted to check in. To find out more about the city of Chicago. I don't even know if any of the city is... I feel like all these hotspots are made-up history. They mention a lot of real people and things that really happened. But I feel like a lot of it, a good deal of it, is not true. Because didn't we check into Cloudgate and it told us something that wasn't about the big giant bean? It's a city hotspot! The Fort Dearborn Massacre! Blah, 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 including 12 children, while another 28 were taken prisoner. 1812? Oh. Perhaps that was related to the War of 1812. It sounds like it. I'm not too familiar with the history of the War of 1812. Of a revolutionary guy myself. On account of the fact that I'm from Massachusetts and, you know, Lexington and Concord were my backyard growing up. Ooh, 3,800. Someone's living high on the hog. Let's bring up the car app. Cars on demand. I want a motorcycle. Oh, that's it right there. Oh, that's it. Let's grab the chopper.
Your chariot awaits.
Thanks, bro. I hate that you can't just deliver it next to me. You have, like, magical teleportation. And you can't either, one, teleport me and skip over the whole owning a car completely. Or teleport the vehicle next to me. Because you literally teleport it. There's no other explanation for the speed at the service you provide. No other explanation whatsoever. In fact, there was an instance where I ordered a car, and I literally saw it pop up in front of me. It was like across the street, but I was watching the area, and it just appeared. It's not like in Grand Theft Auto, where the taxi cab only shows up if you're not looking in its direction. That is... Like, I feel like that mechanic slightly helps sell the illusion of things that aren't just teleported directly on top of you, but if you look away, it's like, well, maybe it was just really fast when it came around the corner. No, no. In this game, it just appears out of fat air. Unfortunately, that does it for this episode of Game Time. Please stay tuned for the next installment of my Watch Dogs Let's Play, where we continue the adventures of Aiden Pearce here in Chicago. But if you prefer not to wait, you can watch the next video right now by clicking the playlist link in the description. As always, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.